All right, so I'm going to be comparing using BlockFi versus Coinbase and which one is better to make money with. Now, I've actually got a pretty cool strategy for using both of these together, which I think is pretty powerful. And of course, if you want to get started on either one of them, I'll throw some bonus and sign-up links in both the description and comments. Now, we had a huge crypto crash, right? My Coinbase account went from having like a couple hundred thousand in it to, you know, the low $100,000 mark, which is frustrating, but I've got some long-term positions on here that I'm just not looking to sell at anytime soon. But, you know, going back a year, you can see I'm still doing really well on Coinbase, you know, up from like 10,000 to, you know, over 100,000. I'm definitely not complaining, right? Now, BlockFi, I just put a little bit more money in. My account's over $1,000 right now. And I've actually had one interest payment on here, you know, for like 19 cents, which is hilarious. But, you know, now that I put more money in it, you know, the accrued interest is going to start, you know, growing. The thing about BlockFi is that it's really not meant for trading, although you could do that on here. It's more about, you know, making passive income, you know, for interest, just for holding certain coins like Bitcoin, Ethereum, Chainlink, Litecoin. Those are some of the options on here. They also let you borrow money on BlockFi, which I haven't checked out yet, but the interest rates are also really low. But this is what I want to say you should try doing. Now, as far as making money goes, you're going to be making a whole lot more if you're actively like swing trading, which is how I've grown my Coinbase account. And of course, Coinbase also has Coinbase Pro, which you could later switch over to, you know, for getting lower fees on trading. But once you make money on Coinbase, I think the smart thing to do would be to put some of that money into BlockFi, you know, for like long-term position holds. Because you could obviously hold a lot of the, you know, Bitcoin or Ethereum or Chainlink on other exchanges. It's just that on BlockFi, you're going to be able to earn 8.6% interest just for holding the coins there. So I'm going to talk about swing trading here on Coinbase once again, and I'm just going to pull up a coin that I've done pretty well with this year, honestly, as far as like, you know, trading in its Bitcoin Cash. Now, in total, you know, I think, you know, I lost some money back, but I think I'm up about 40,000 buying and selling Bitcoin Cash. And what I've done, you know, is what's called swing trading. So it's just when you're buying, you know, when the crypto market crashes and then you sell, you know, when it recovers, usually anywhere from like a few percent up to like 10%. And then you just sell your position, you know, and then rinse and repeat the process. Now, the thing about swing trading is sometimes you get stuck in a trade and you don't know how long you're going to be in it. You know, for example, I've had times where I've gotten in and out of Bitcoin Cash, but then there were times where I had to hold the coin for, you know, a couple months or a few months, you know, just to wait to sell it. But the whole point here is when you're making some money doing, you know, active trading, why not take some of that cash, put it into BlockFi, you know, kind of like as a long-term thing. And when I say long-term, I mean, you know, years down the road. And then, you know, you'll have like a really good chunk on BlockFi just paying you, you know, passive income and interest, you know, every single month. And the cool thing about BlockFi is that they do pay once a month, every month, the interest you earn. And it's usually just like on whatever, like the 30th or the 31st, from what I've seen. But it's pretty cool. So yeah, anyways, I added some money here on BlockFi. I'm going to continue doing so in the coming months just to kind of, you know, show you how, you know, my progression is going with BlockFi. But so far, so good. Okay, anyways, hope you guys enjoyed this comparison. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. But just combine both of them, and I think that would be the smart move. All right, thanks for watching it, guys, and we'll see you in the next one.